Welcome to the Unstuck podcast. I'm your host, Sean Miner. This weekly no-fluff mindset show arms you with the practical tools you need to get unstuck so you can get exactly what you want out of life. Remember, when you change your mind, your life will follow. Let's get into today's episode. Hey there, friends. Thank you so much for joining me on this Tuesday edition of Unstuck. We have another listener Q&A episode for you, this time focused on the category of love and relationships, which is one of my favorite things to talk about because I have been through it all, and we'll get to that. First, just a quick reminder to head over, if you haven't already, and grab your high vibe digital wallpapers from my digital wallpaper library that I created free just for you. And by I created, I mean not me at all. My designer created these amazing, beautiful, high vibe wallpapers for you to deck out all of your electronics, your desktop, your laptop, your phones, your iPads, whatever you have. Deck them all out in these high vibe reminders. Every time you look at your electronic devices, which for most of us is quite a bit, you can have that as your screensaver and just get that little boost. And right now we are working on adding new wallpapers for the month. We're going to do this every month, so you will always have a chance to mix it up, because I think we can all agree, and if you have your wallpaper on your phone or your desktop right now, you already have noticed that it's probably become part of the background at this point. You're not really noticing it. So it's important to mix these up quite a bit and give your eye something new to look at, something new to catch on to and absorb, and of course, increase your vibration. So new ones will be added very soon once you are part of the library. So once you have gained access to the library, you always have access to the library. So you can come in every single month and get a new wallpaper and see the new designs, see which ones resonate with you for that period of your life. Right now, there are 7 out there already. We're going to be adding some more soon. So get access now, seanminer.com/wallpapers. Head over there, grab yours, get access, change them up as many times as you want. Put different ones on every single electronic device you have. A new high vibe reminder everywhere you turn. All right, that's it for announcements and reminders and all that good stuff. Let's get into today's listener question and, of course, my answer to that question. I'll start with the very basic question and then get into a little bit of the details behind the question based on this listener's experience and what she's currently going through. The bottom line question is, can I unstick my ho-hum relationship, or is it time to get out? Now, the backstory is they have been in a relationship for a very long time, about 6 years. The first few years were great. About 2 years were great. Spent all this time together, really got connected. We're having an amazing time, an amazing relationship together. And then after that, things kind of started to unravel. The over-connection got the best of both of them, and they needed some time apart. They needed to find themselves again. And since then, it's been a little rocky. There's been a breakup in there and a get back together situation. Now they're basically in a place where they live together and are in a relationship, but it has become more of a friendship slash roommate situation and less of a romantic in love situation. And there's just a lot of lack of communication, just kind of almost to a place where they don't want to ruffle each other's feathers or talk about the deep stuff, because it ends up being a lot of difference of opinion and some things that can and can't be worked out, some shutdown moments, things like that going on. There's a lot of emotions behind what they both need. And at this point, it's almost just gotten to a point where it's better if they don't talk about it and just kind of live different lives, but then remain under the same roof and remain connected in that way. you can see then that the question becomes, do I stay in this relationship and do the work to figure it out and see if we still have a connection beyond roommates, or do I get out? And of course, I have some advice that I want to give. I do want to keep it rather general. This is obviously a very specific situation. There's some deep stuff going on here. There's some stuff that may or may not be able to be worked out, and they have their own kind of scenario to go through. But what I want to share today is applicable to a lot more than just that type of scenario. Really, anybody, even if you're not in a relationship and you're looking for the perfect match for you, or you're in a relationship and you don't know if it's still the right person, if it ever was the right person, if it's something that you want to work out or not, if you're kind of waiting for the perfect opportunity to separate, or you don't know if you should. There's a lot. There's always a lot to unpack when it comes to relationships. And so I want to keep it rather general so that we all can benefit from this. Every single person can get some benefit from this. Even if you're in the most amazing relationship, this still is something to do either right now or in the future. If you do start having some disconnect between the two of you, this is also something for you to consider then. Now, before I get into my advice, I want to remind you all that this is advice. My first kind of thought when I have these types of questions is like, am I even qualified to answer this question? Because I'm not a therapist. I'm definitely not a relationship therapist or a couples therapist. I'm not a relationship expert, I would say, even. When it comes to relationships and really a lot of other things I will end up chatting about on this show, I'm just a real person with some what I consider to be really good advice. I've always taken the role of advice giver for my friends, especially when it comes to relationships. So I'm used to that role. I enjoy that role. And now that's what I want to do for you here on this show with your listener questions. Take it or leave it. It's just advice. If it works for you, great. If it sounds awesome, cool with me. If it doesn't, that's also cool. I'm totally fine with you leaving it and not doing these things. Why do I feel a little bit more secure in talking about relationships specifically and love specifically is because I have been through a lot when it comes to relationships. I've been in some really bad relationships. I've been in some really dramatic relationships. I've been cheated on and then became best friends with that person. I also was single for 6 years straight in my 30s and really got to the point where I didn't think I was going to find love ever. And guess what broke that streak so that I could meet the love of my life, who I am now with? My dream partner, it was this mindset work. It was my desire to meet someone and the mindset work that I did around that process that I literally 100% have no doubt in my mind manifested my dream relationship. Every box on my list was checked with my partner now. So what did I learn from all of this experience? Everything that I've been through, all the crappy relationships, all the relationships where we were just friends and kind of going through the motions of being in a relationship, all the like really awful, devastating breakups where I did not think I would ever be normal again and not be sad again. What did I learn from all this? The exact person that you want and the exact relationship that you want is out there. I know you've probably heard this before, but I want to repeat it because I was someone also who heard this all the time. It's like, yeah, whatever. I don't think that's true. I think I'm just going to be single forever because it's easier than dating the wrong person. And that's kind of where I was at. But then I really did find someone that checked all the boxes off. So that means there's absolutely no reason to settle and try to make something work that isn't right, or get into a relationship where you just don't feel that feeling, or there are red flags all over the place, or even yellow flags all over the place. but you ignore that because you want to be in a relationship, there's no reason to do that because it can and should be amazing like 90% of the time. It can be. And you can find that person. They are out there for you. So that's kind of the one thing I wanted to say, my one little cheerleader thing that I did want to start with. The second thing I want to say before I get into this tool you can use is to just let you know that I'm not telling you whether you should break up or divorce or stay together with your partner. That is not my role here. That's not what I want to do because that is, of course, 100% up to you and your partner. But I do want to give you a tool that you can use to evaluate how it's going and if it's close to what you want and if there's something that you can do or your partner can do or you both can do together to make it a little closer or if that's even something that you want to do. So let's go through this little tool I have for you to do. Also, this tool works for everyone, whether you are in a relationship or not. This is something for all of us to do. Even if you're in a great relationship, like I said, and everything's going wonderfully, this is something you can do to make sure it stays that way. Or if things start getting a little rocky or you start having a little bit of conflict, this is something you can go back to get your bearings for both of you. And again, I did this. This is the exact thing that I did. Maybe I will show you over on my Instagram my list because I still have it. This is exactly what I did when I wasn't in a relationship and wanted one. This was part of the mindset work I did to get my perfect partner. So definitely do this regardless of whether you're in a relationship or not. We are creating a list. It's that easy. We're just creating a list. Now, this is not a list of characteristics. This is not like, oh, I want this person to be 6 feet tall, brown hair, super funny, nice build, big feet, whatever. This is not that. In fact, I would encourage you to get rid of the characteristic list entirely. That is setting you up for failure. Trust me, I had a characteristic list about a mile long by the time I was done with all of this, and I got rid of it entirely. Got rid of every little tiny aspect that I thought I wanted my partner to look like, be like, do, have, all of that stuff. I got rid of all that, started from scratch, and instead created a list of how I wanted to feel in that relationship and what I wanted to do with that person. So that's the list you are going to create. Scratch everything else. What does your dream relationship look and feel like? Now again, if you're in a relationship, I want you to get into a dreamland place. Don't consider your current relationship. Just get into a place where no matter what your current partner does or doesn't do, can't, won't do, or be, or anything like that, write it down exactly as your dream relationship, whether that's what you currently have or not, whether that's something that's even possible in your current relationship or not, write it down, create that list. And of course, if you're not in a relationship at all, just totally dream whatever you want, whatever is important. But remember, it's only what does it feel like? So how do you feel in that relationship? Is it love, security, friendship, companionship, fun, adventure, joy, whatever it is, how does it feel? And then what does it look like? So what do you guys do together? Do you cuddle? Do you go for hikes? Do you go out to dinner? Do you go bowling? Do you watch Netflix together? Do you work together? What do you do together? So how does your life look with that dream partner? Those are the two questions. You can kind of separate them. Start with feel, then go down to look if you want. However that list comes about for you is cool. Now, if you are in a current relationship, draw a line, and now I want you next to it to write a list of how your current relationship looks and feels, and include both the good and the bad. So what do you guys do together or not do together? And how do you feel in that relationship? The good and the bad. Don't hold back. No one's going to see this but you. Well, maybe your partner will someday if you want them to, but just be very clear and very honest, because of course, now we are going to compare those two lists so that you can find out where your current relationship is excelling and what it's really bringing into your life that you truly want and how you want to feel, and where does it need some work. So what needs to happen for these two lists to line up? Where are you connected with what you want? And where are you disconnected from what you want with your partner, with your current relationship? And then, of course, what can you do to get them to match a little better? And then what can your partner do to get them to match a little better? And what can you do as a couple? Start considering it and brainstorming it on your own. And then I think it would be wonderful to bring this up and talk about it with your partner to just kind of show, this is what is really important to me in a relationship. And this is how I want to feel. And this is what I want us to do together. And this is where we currently are. These are the great things about our relationship. This is how awesome you make me feel in these certain scenarios. But there are also some things that we could potentially work on. I'd love for us to go out on more dates. I'd love for us to cuddle more or go out on walks more, something like that, where you now have a little bit of a list of things that are really important to you that aren't happening. And there's things that you can do. It's not just putting it all on your partner, but there's things that you can do together. Like you can schedule date night, or you can put it in your calendar to go on a walk after work together, or spend some time without our phones to cuddle. There's things that you can do together as a couple to start putting in the effort to make those lists line up. And then, of course, there might be things that you can do that's just you that will really make things start lining up. And then there are probably some things that your partner can do to make things line up on those two lists. So bring it up, talk about it, make the connection, see what it is that you want that you're not currently getting and how you want to feel that you're not currently feeling, and go from there. Now, you may find that these lists are very different, like how you want to feel and experience a relationship is very different than what you currently have going on, or you can't see one or the other or both of you committing to make these changes to get them to match up, or you just don't want to, or your partner isn't into it and just wants to keep it as is, then it's time to evaluate if it is the right partner for you. Or maybe it's time to go see someone and get some professional help or do a little bit more digging. And this is where you can really start that process. But I think the first step is to really see and get a feel for where you're currently sitting in your relationship. How close is it to what you want, to your dream relationship? And then go from there and have an open, honest conversation with the other party of this relationship to see if it's something that they are willing and committed to do to get those to line up more. And it honestly, this could be a really great tool for your partner to do as well. Have them create their own list of dream relationship goals, how they want to feel and what they want to do in a dream relationship, and see how it lines up for them. And then see what you guys can do together to really create this master list of things that are important to both of you and how you can do that, how you can get them to line up. So tons of stuff we can do here with just this simple tool, this simple list creation. The reason why I love this exercise and this tool, and I really think that we all can benefit from it in all types of relationships, or even if you're single, and I'll get into the single status in just a second, But remember the ultimate goal. Again, I'm going to go back to this. The ultimate goal of all existence, of our time here, is to feel the way you want to feel as much as possible. And of course, we spend a ton of time being in relationships and being with our partner and trying to find a good match for us to spend a lot of time with. So that means you are really entrusting this other person to make you feel the way you want to feel when you're around them. So feeling loved and safe and having that companionship and having fun with each other, all of these are very much necessary to create a high vibe life and a high vibe relationship, which is really the ultimate goal of our time here on this planet, but also in order to keep the rest of your life in a high vibe place too. And if we go all the way back to when we talked about vibration, and specifically as it relates to your physical body, even if you want to be healthier or to create more abundance in your life or to have more connection in your life, anything that is a high vibration, it requires the rest of your world to also be in a high vibe place. And I cannot tell you the amount of women I have worked with who are having physical symptoms that they just cannot figure out and more health issues. And turns out it really all stemmed from having some unspoken needs in their relationship or not feeling comfortable and secure in their relationship or just not being in the right relationship. So much of it comes down to, so much else that we have going on in our lives comes back to the status of our relationship. So I really want you all, no matter what your current status is, to really do some work on this. And if you are single status, we'll get to this now, all you're doing is creating that want list, how you want to feel and what you want to do with your partner, and letting the how or who leave that up to the universe and just focus on how you want to feel and what you see yourself doing, and visualize that and affirm that and be excited for the future with that in your life, and focus on that feeling and work to get those feelings now. Remember, we've gone through all of this in past episodes, but that's all you are going to do with this list. You are going to be confident that that person is out there and on its way to you. The universe is connecting you guys as we speak. Just get excited for that and start feeling it now. Get ready. It's coming your way, I promise. Now, I have one last thing to say. I couldn't let this episode go by without also including this. So beyond this list tool, which we all can do and should do, the very, very best way to know for sure if you should be with a person or not, or when it's time to end one relationship chapter of your life, so perhaps another one can open. How to know for sure? Your intuition, of course. What is your inner self telling you to do? Your soul, what is it guiding you towards? Not what would be easiest for your life or what your head wants or even what your heart wants, but what is that deep internal knowing, that deep down voice? What is it telling you? What does it want for you? Remember, your intuition, your soul, your inner guidance system knows what is best for you and is also connected to the universe or your higher power. So it's going to lead you in the right direction for you to live your best, highest self life. How do we do that? Well, again, I would suggest, if you aren't totally tapped into your intuition, I would suggest going back to episode 7 and listening to that episode about letting your intuition be your guide. But the tool I recommend from that episode is doing a journaling practice to get your intuition out. So the first step is to let your ego take over for a second. Have a blank page. Let yourself write all of your concerns, all of your fears, all of your safety zone type stuff. That's all coming from your ego, which is very loud, is very prominent, it's very easy to write all that stuff. Those thoughts are right there, right in the forefront. Get all that out. When that's quiet, now you can take a deep breath, relax, close your eyes maybe, give yourself a few minutes to settle in, let that ego take a back seat, and then wait for the answer from your intuition. So what does your intuition say is the best course of action for this particular situation? Remember, your inner voice, your intuition is often going to be quiet. It's going to be succinct. It may not even be a full sentence. It may just be a few really important words that you can piece together, but wait for it and allow it to come through and trust it. You will probably find that as soon as that comes through, you will feel a sense of ease and knowing, but you may also find that immediately your ego gets back involved and starts questioning that and gets right back into it, especially if you haven't done this work a lot. We'll start getting that fear-based stuff. We'll start having those fear-based emotions or the comfort zone emotions. So beware, but just go back to that first spot where you had that inner knowing and head back there and do this work as much as you need to. That inner voice of yours is always the best advice giver, the one that really knows. So really, my advice is to listen to the best advice giver. All right, those are my tips for you today. If you are in a relationship right now that you don't know you should be in, that you don't know it can be saved, please take this tip and see what you can do with it and see what comes up for you. And again, if you're single, do this too. The best thing I ever did. I am so grateful I took this lesson and practiced it because now I have it. It really, truly worked and it will work for you too. And if you're in a relationship and it's great and wonderful, then you're feeling all the feels right now. But this is also a really good tool to keep in your back pocket. And as you progress, just always be reminded of how awesome it is to be in this spot where those lists are matching up for you, and be grateful for that and appreciate your partner and your relationship for what it is. It will always keep you in that high vibe place and you will never start taking it for granted when you are in a good spot in your relationship. That is it for today. If this resonated with you, or if you know someone who may be having some trouble in their relationship or having trouble with being single, please send this episode to them. I'd be happy to chat with them too. And don't forget, come find me on Instagram at Sean Miner and send me a message if you have a question you would like answered on the show. I'm loving all the questions I'm getting. You guys are awesome and I am thoroughly enjoying being your advice giver, lifting you up, raising your vibration, reminding you what's really important, and giving you some new tools to use in your own life. Until next time, take care.